important that people understand the harm of Christian Zionism and blind support for the nation state of Israel. Because as someone who grew up in the church myself, who experienced a lot of Christian Zionist teaching and ideology, I don't think people realize how the Western church and Christian Zionism in America has contributed to a culture that allows people to comfortably turn a blind eye to genocide out of what they believe to be reverence for God. Just look at this video.
And for the Palestinian Christians who would say to you, "We are actively being oppressed by the state of Israel. We're persecuted here." What do you say to them?
I would say, take a look at the scriptures and love them and be a blessing in any way you can, even if you're being persecuted. What did Jesus say? He said, turn the cheek.
Imagine your response to Palestinians who have to routinely pull their family members' body parts out of the rubble being that they should turn the other cheek, that they should take joy in their oppression and occupation, that they should find a way. That woman is an American evangelical who moved to Israel out of what she felt was a calling from God to be a blessing to Israel. And her love for Israel, like many Christians in America and the West, is rooted in what she believes to be a command from God.
Most Christians will tell you, well, we love Israel because God says, I will bless those who bless my people.
It is important that every Christian knows that the Israel of the Bible, I'll call it ancient Israel, is not the Israel that is being talked about today. I'll call it modern Israel. They share the same name, but they're not remotely the same entities.
People think that Israel is some kind of continuation of a Jewish government, but it's not. It's a completely different form of government, completely different values, completely different ideology, and completely different people. These are not religious Jews that are running the country. These are atheists. And yet, the Israeli prime ministers, from Ben-Gurion all the way up to Netanyahu, use the Bible as an excuse for ownership of the land.
Ancient Israel was a theocratic monarchy in covenant with their god, Yahweh, a covenant rooted in the Torah and the law of Moses. It was a collection of tribes and their descendants. It was not a nation state as we understand it today, but a diverse group of related people with a primarily spiritual and religious identity. Ancient Israel existed within a specific geographic and historical context, with narratives that include ancient history, myth, religious teachings, and allegory. The modern Israel is a nation state. It defines itself as a secular liberal democracy. It makes no official claim to be in divine covenant, and doesn't really have the Torah or the Bible as the basis of its laws. The modern state of Israel, established in 1948, is a settler colony like America is. It is a product of contemporary politics, diplomacy, and the 20th century Zionist movement. It is a heavily militarized apartheid state that is year by year actively displacing a nation of people, the Palestinians, trying to ethnically cleanse the land and use the Bible as justification to do so.
Here's something that might surprise you. White evangelical Christians in the U.S. are more than twice as likely as American Jews to believe that God gave Israel to the Jewish people. People that share this view are called Christian Zionists. They believe the Bible commands them to support and defend the modern-day state of Israel, regardless of what this means for the Palestinians who live under its occupation.
Christian Zionism historically gave religious merit to the taking of land from the Palestinians, and today is one of the main reasons why Israel is able to garner support from American evangelicals, including those in politics like newly elected House Speaker Mike Johnson, who sought to give $14.3 billion in military aid to Israel alone in his first act in the new role.
The first bill that I'm going to bring to this floor in just a little while will be in support of our dear friend Israel, and we're overdue in getting that done.
Restorationist Protestants, we call them evangelical Christians today, they existed hundreds of years before any Jewish Zionist was ever born. And because the evangelicals, the restorationists, had great influence in Britain, and Britain had the mandate, the Zionists very, very much adopted the Christian evangelical interpretation of the Bible. And that's what they use today.
There is a genocide unfolding in Palestine. It is being spearheaded by Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, and it plays on the religious convictions and the fears of American evangelicals to support the Zionist movement for a Jewish state, regardless of who gets harmed in the process. I mention fear because Zionist propaganda is even included in the Left Behind movies and books that many of us consumed over the years. These books and movies impacted millions around the world, and people still suffer from religious trauma because of them. And these fears of the end of the world, of being left behind, is heightened in this moment.
It looks like the Israeli Air Force never sleeps.
Those are not our planes. Not from that direction.
What's going on?
It's a full-scale air attack. No warning.
By who?
Could be anyone. No one has more enemies who want to see her destroyed than Israel.
Many evangelicals believe that once Jews fully control the land, Jesus will return to earth and rapture Christians up to heaven.
To believers, it's going to be a time of ecstasy and joy and excitement and glory. But to those who do not know him, it's going to be a day of judgment.
The fear of being cursed by God for not blessing Israel, the push by many conservatives for the end of the world to come, is doing nothing but adding fuel to the fire of this genocide. Benjamin Netanyahu said it himself, "I don't believe the Jewish state and modern Zionism would be possible without Christian Zionism." His words. In fact, in a speech given to the John Hagee-founded Christians United for Israel, or CUFI, in 2019, Netanyahu personally thanked American evangelicals for their support of Israel.
Now there millions and millions of devout Christians who stand with Israel. So I want to thank you on behalf of all the people of Israel.
And we see clearly why now.
The title deed to the land of Israel is recorded in the Bible, which gives the Jewish people a clear and unclouded title to that land forever. It belongs to them, and it belongs to them only.
It's estimated that every year, evangelicals give around $200 million to Israel. And some organizations specifically raise money for Israeli settlements in the occupied West Bank, which are illegal under international law.
Pastor John Hagee is a man who I grew up watching, a man who my grandfather, may he rest, deeply admired. He's the leading evangelical voice for Christian Zionism today, and his organization, Christians United for Israel, has about 10 million members. That is more people than the entire Jewish population in America. Think about that. And within the Christian Zionist movement, we see the harms of trying to read the Bible onto the history of the nation-state of Israel. For example, we see John Hagee provide biblical rationale for the Holocaust.
Then God sent a hunter. A hunter is someone who comes with a gun, and he forces you. Hitler was a hunter. Why did it happen? Because God said, my top priority for the Jewish people is to get them to come back to the land of Israel.
We hear the belief about how the violent establishment of the state of Israel in 1948 is somehow fulfilled prophecy, that the Nakba, the taking of land from the Palestinians and displacing them, and the thousands of Palestinians who were killed by Jewish Zionists to make that happen was a part of God's plan.
We see all over God's word that the Jewish people at a certain point in history would begin to find their way back home. And we know that happened in May 1948 when the state became a real nation. And ever since then, the Jewish people have been coming home. It's a miracle, and we've been living in Bible prophecy ever since.
And what these ideas reflect more than anything is how the religion of white supremacy and colonialism shows up in Western readings of the Bible, a fact recognized by those across the world impacted by how we read the Bible.
So I'll say that Christian Zionism in general is a very colonial way of reading the Bible and also a very white supremacist type of viewing of the Bible.
Evangelicals read the Bible in a very literal and simple way. They believe that you have to bless Israel so that God blesses you. They see in it an image of God who is a tribal God who favors one nation over everyone else.
Womanist scholar Dr. Missy Smith said this regarding biblical interpretation. The impact of our contemporary context, like the air in the room, is inescapable. And since we live in a nation that is a centuries-old settler colonial project, one that acquired land by the same violent means, and that also used the Bible to justify it along with the enslavement of Africans, it's important for everyone to be mindful, to be critical, of how white supremacy and colonialism are showing up in these interpretations of the Bible. Because if not, it is easy to find yourself supporting a repeating of the very same historical atrocities that Christians claim to stand against today.
There's another chapter in this story, and the chapter of the story is Europe didn't want the Jews, North America didn't want the Jews, Australia didn't want the Jews, and the quote-unquote Jewish problem gets quote-unquote solved by spatially displacing it onto Palestine, and the mantle of whiteness gets passed to the Jews, and it's their turn. And yeah. This is somehow imagined as reparations, except it's replication. So we are in this historical loop, but this is why, you know, we have to admit that Israel is founded in trauma. Like it is both a replica of settler colonialism and also a new iteration of it, because it's being cast as reparations for genocide. This is a new twist. And if we can't sort of look at that complexity and understand how central it is to Israel's own narrative of itself, I'm not sure we get out of the loop.
I can't put this any more plainly. To blindly support the settler colony of Israel, to uphold the mantle of Christian Zionism even now, is to support the ethnic cleansing of the Palestinian people, is to support their genocide. And everyone from peers to politicians to pastors should be better informed, and if need be, held accountable for their support of this apartheid state that we know today as Israel. Love and liberation to you all, and as always, like and follow for more content.
You think they should love their oppressor?
I don't believe that Israel is oppressing them.
When you're talking, I feel like there's a lot of support and elevation of the Jewish people having Israel. But doesn't that contradict the principles of equality that Christianity preaches?
Well, then I think we'd have to go back to God and ask him why he chose the Jewish people. I think the key is study what God says, not what man says.